Hey, Jason Creel, and this is the Lawn Care Life. Well, it's October in Alabama, and I am looking to overseed my lawn with ryegrass. Now, I'm going to tell you my thoughts on this and show you how I'm doing it and the rate that I'm using for grass seed. But I want to show you the property and just explain to you the thought behind me overseeding first, and then explain and show you how to do it. Let's get started right now. Today's video is sponsored by my friends at Yardbook. Yardbook is the software I use to run my lawn care business. There's a link in the description if you want to check it out. Okay, so some people that follow the channel regular have seen kind of the renovation of my property. A lot of this was woods and trees, and I've plugged Bermuda grass over the past 2 years. And for the most part, it's actually looking pretty good. Now, you know, it's filled in. You can see Bermuda out there. And as I go into the front yard, there's gonna be a lot of Bermuda that you can see in the distance. And the front yard is almost solid Bermuda. But we did a big home renovation, and with that came a lot of dirt grading, okay? So there's areas of the yard like this where the dirt was graded out. And this was actually where the former gravel driveway used to be, so it's going to be not ideal soil by any means, even though we brought in a little topsoil, but there's a lot of rocks, and I may have to, you know, bring in some more dirt. But point being, there's very little grass here. Now, there's a little bit of Bermuda. I'm gonna probably plug some Bermuda in over the course of the fall, and hopefully get this to spread next year. But for the meantime, I want to overseed it with ryegrass. And I'm not just looking to overseed this area where there's, you know, on this area. So in this area, I'm basically looking for something to hold the dirt, because this is gonna be an absolute mud hole out here this winter if I don't have any kind of grass. So I'm basically looking for something to hold the dirt in place and for cosmetically to look better than a mud pit. But while I'm doing that, I might go ahead and overseed, you know, some of the rest of it, so it's not just an odd shape area of bright green grass with lots of brown grass. So some of this other area that does have some Bermuda, I'm gonna go ahead and put some grass seed out here too, and maybe just kind of have my whole backyard overseeded. Not my entire backyard, but this area immediately behind the house, overseed it right here. So let me show you what I'm doing, explain to you what to do, what not to do, and give you some of the how-tos, and then we'll demonstrate. Okay, so I'm gonna be putting it out with a ride-on spreader sprayer here. I'm just gonna dump the whole bag in the hopper. And I went yesterday to a local seed store, and I bought a 50-pound bag of annual ryegrass. Now, annual ryegrass is cheaper than perennial ryegrass, but it doesn't look quite as good. But I went with cheap because this is not a permanent solution for me. This is mostly to hold the dirt in place. And yes, I want it to look nice and green and even in the areas that I am overseeding. But yeah, perennial ryegrass would be a better choice, but I went with annual ryegrass. Now, as far as the rate goes, I've read everything from 5 to 15 pounds per 1,000 square feet. I'm gonna try to go somewhere in the middle, around 8 pounds per 1,000 square feet. Obviously, if you put it thicker, it's gonna come up and, you know, be a thicker looking lawn. But I think, I'm not looking for permanent stand of grass here. I'm looking for something temporary just to make it look decent over the course of the winter. Some other things you could do if you're overseeding a Bermuda lawn is to go ahead and scalp your Bermuda down a little bit lower to allow the grass seed to get down there into the soil. Aerating would be a great idea if you have the ability to do that. I know a lot of the guys in cool season grass, they're aerating and overseeding at this time of year. Again, I'm dealing with horrible rocky dirt, and there'll be no aeration, no loosening of the soil. I'm just throwing it straight down. But one of the main things you want to do is get the timing right. And I texted a friend of mine last night, and I said, hey, do you think it's too early to put out the ryegrass? And he said, no, I looked at the forecast coming up, and I don't see any really hot weather. I mean, we're down like upper 70s, low 80s. And the reason I'm wanting to do it today, because there's a great chance of rain for the next 3 days in my area. So if you're in a situation like me in the south, you want to wait till the temperatures start cooling off. You want to see if there's some rain in the forecast, unless you're able to water it yourself with irrigation. But in my situation, I want the rain to do the watering for me. One thing you definitely don't want to do if you're going to overseed your Bermuda grass is don't put a pre-emergent out before you spray. I had a story last year, customer that doesn't normally overseed their lawn. I spray Spectacle Flow on my yards in the fall. He's got a Bermuda lawn, and well, I show up you know, last year and sprayed his yard like I normally do, just his front yard, and I don't do his backyard. Well, later on in the winter, guess what? His backyard is lush and green, where he'd overseed it with ryegrass, and his front yard had little patches of real pathetic looking ryegrass where he had overseed it, but I had already sprayed spectacle, so the germination was pitiful. So anyway, I'm a don't spray pre-emergent. And the other thing is, if you want to get rid of, yeah, this annual ryegrass, it'll die out eventually, next, I don't know, April or May, but it grows like crazy in the springtime. When the weather starts warming up in March, I mean, it's growing so fast. Sometimes I get tired of it, and ultimately I'm wanting my Bermuda grass to fill in. So I use a product called Katana that will knock it out. So if you get tired of looking at it, and you might can even go with glyphosate on a dormant Bermuda lawn if you get tired of it, but you don't want to do that on into March or April, because you're going to probably stunt your Bermuda. So let me dump it in the hopper, and we're going to get to spreading. And I'm not going to be able to show you the actual results of what it looks like green in this particular video, but I wanted to kind of talk to you about the how-tos and the whys, and show you my property. And maybe in future videos, I imagine we'll be showing this grass so you can see the results. So I encourage you to subscribe to the channel if you hadn't done so. I don't do a lot of overseeding, so I'm not exactly sure how to set my dial, so I'm gonna set it a little low, and if I need to actually go over it a couple times or adjust the dial, I can, to get it dialed in on the amount of grass seed I'm trying to put out for this amount of area. Appreciate you watching the video. I'm Jason Creel. Hopefully this taught you a little bit of how to go about overseeding your lawn if you're going to try to do it. Again, there's better ways you could use. You could aerate, till up the soil, use perennial ryegrass, things like that. But hopefully, just wanted to give you an idea of what to do and what I'm doing on my lawn. I'll put a couple of links in the description. One is the Lawn Care Life. That's my website. There's Weed Control and Fertilization Academy that's been popular for people that want to start a weed control and fertilization business. I'm also combining that with a live training class starting November 3rd for those that are interested in that. Documents, things like that, lawncarelife.com. Also, if you're going to the GIE Expo and you hadn't signed up yet, you can use, I'll put a link in the description for that. For my code, you can get 50% off your registration. Hope to see many of you there this year. Thanks for watching. Talk to you later. Bye.